G'day and welcome to another video. In today's lesson, we're going to learn how to make this really cute sweater. As you can see, it can be made in long sleeve or short. This video is from a preemie size and it is up to child sizes. All the information that you need is in the written pattern and the link for that will be in the description box below. The white one that you can see is using DK yarn and that is the preemie size. The pink one is using the same pattern, but it is made using a worsted weight or a 10-ply yarn. And as you can see, it's turned out about one size larger. So you can use DK or worsted weight for this pattern. I am now on Patreon, so I would love for you guys to check me out over there. The link that you need is in the description box. We will be starting giveaways and there's early bird links to video tutorials so you can see them before everybody else. There's also behind the scene photos and we do have random giveaways over there as well. So like I said, the link that you need for Patreon is in the description box below the video. So let's get started on the lesson. If you would like to see more crochet tutorials, please subscribe as we do have video tutorials every week and it's always on something new and exciting. To look at more of my videos, click on my username and that will take you straight to my channel. For our supplies, we're going to need a pair of scissors, a yarn needle with a large eye, easy for sewing in. You're going to need a pencil or a pen to jot down some measurements, a crochet hook to go with your yarn. I've got a 5.5mm or a eye size crochet hook. You're going to need a tape measure. Can you see a colour theme going on here? You're going to need a tape measure and also some yarn. I'm using Red Heart Super Saver. You can use any worsted weight yarn. You can also use double knit or 8-ply. Worsted weight is about a 10-ply for us Australians. And if you're going to use the 8-ply or double knit yarn, I would suggest a 4mm or a G size crochet hook. This is not a full skein of yarn. I am working from my stash because I am on a yarn ban. There is such a thing. And it will not take the whole ball for the small size, which is what I'm going to do for the video tutorial. You will also need your written pattern. Yours will look a little bit different to mine because I haven't finished the photo, so I haven't inserted it yet. And we're going to work our way through the pattern. We will be taking some measurements, which is where these arrows are. And then we've got the instructions. So what you will need to do, and I'm going to insert some photos to show you what I'm talking about. You're going to go find a shirt or a sweater that is in the size that you want to make. Now this video is for the child size ones, so you will need to find a child size sweater or a top that they wear. If you don't have that on hand, I will put a link in the description box below and that will give you some child sizes and you can use those measurements to make this sweater. So this is not a word for word pattern, it's just a recipe and we've got all the details there and like it's got the DK yarn and then your worsted weight yarn with your crochet hook size. And what we're going to do, once you've completed row one, you're going to know if it's going to fit the size that you want because we're going to compare row one to the size that we're making it for. And this is the opening of the sweater, so it's going to be the neck opening of your sweater that you're making. And it's very easy to adjust the armhole depth, which is where this red arrow is. So here we have our neck. The size we need it, we're good to go. So what you're going to do is you're going to grab your tape measure and your Garmin and you are going to measure around the neck. And I'm going to insert a photo now. And then we are going to write it down here. So I got 30 centimeters. We're then going to measure the armhole depth. And I'm going to insert a photo here. And then we're going to write that measurement there. You'll notice that the item that I'm measuring is an adult size garment. It is actually one of my tops, but the measuring is done exactly the same way. Of course, you're just going to give a different measurement. We are going to measure the length of the top from the bottom, so right up the top here to right down the bottom, and then we're going to write that measurement there. And I'm going to insert a photo now. And again, you can see that it's an adult size top, but the measuring, where you're going to measure it, is exactly the same method. Again, if you don't have a top that you've got, you can use that information chart that I'm going to give you a link for, and that's pretty much got all the measurements that you need there. So on to the next page. The next page is the... Okay, so this isn't filled out properly yet, but it will be... Scribble, scribble. It will be filled out properly when you go to the written pattern. And it's got the DK yarn and then worsted weight yarn, which is 10 ply. It's got the unstretched measurement of the neck hole when you use the DK yarn and also when you use the worsted weight yarn. And then it's going to give approximate size that this is going to fit, but you can also compare this first round to the neck opening on the sweater or the garment that you're using. And then it's just got the amount of chains that we're using for that. And then we have the instructions. So I will be following along with the smallest size. So I will be following chain 40. Then I'll be doing that first number there, and then the first number here, and so on. So I'm always doing the first number. If you're going to do a different size and you're going to need to compare all your measurements, you might need to use a different size. I need to edit this pattern, I've just realised. So they won't actually be there, and neither will that. I've just realised, I've still got that in there. But anyway, so you're going to either be doing chain of a 40 or a chain of 52, 64, 76 or 88. So once you know what size you're making, you are going to circle the size. So I am going to be doing the smallest one because I'm going to make it for worsted weight. It's going to fit about a newborn. So I'm going to do that one. I'm sorry for the state of this pattern. I'm actually quite embarrassed about that. But yes, your version will not look like this. So because I chose the first number, when I come along here, I'm going to be doing the 4. So I'm going to circle that one. Oops. And if you're doing a larger size, you're going to circle whatever size you're going to do. And then I'm going to do 12. You're going to circle whatever size you need to do. And then here we've got a 4. Again, you're going to do what you're doing. And I've got a 12 over there. And I circle with a pencil so that when I'm reading the pattern, I know exactly what number I'm going to go to, and all these other numbers don't confuse me. So if you were smack bang in the middle, you might accidentally do the next number up, and then your stitch count is going to be completely out. Yeah, so we can continue with the rest of the pattern when we get to it. So grabbing your yarn and crochet hook, we're going to make a slip knot. You can do this any way you like. And what we need to do is we need to leave, I might actually make that a bit longer just to be safe, about a 4 to 6 inch tail. And this is going to, that's probably a little bit more, but doesn't matter. That is going to be what we're using to sew the opening closed when we've finished our project. Not the neck opening, just the little tiny bit that we get left over. Otherwise we wouldn't be able to wear it. Right, so I need a chain 40, and you are going to chain however many that you need to do. So we are going to double crochet into the fifth chain from the crochet hook, and this counts as the increase. So it'll be a double crochet, chain one, and that's what it will count as. And then we're about to do the second half of the increase. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So one chain counts as our chain one, and the other three count as our double crochet. So we're going to, oops, we're going to work into the chain and work our double crochet. So now you can see that counts as an increase. It's like a little V. Then we are going to double crochet, and I need to do it into the next four stitches, and you will do it into however many that you need to do. And then we need to do our increase, and that's a double crochet, chain one, double crochet into the next chain. So in our next chain, we need to double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. Now we need to double crochet into the next 12 stitches. And again, if you're making a different size, you will crochet into however many that you need to do. So I need to go into the next 12 stitches, so I'll do that now. Into the next stitch, we're going to work an increase, so it's a double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. That's all into the same stitch. You can see that there. So the bit that we just did, our 12 stitches, or this, the largest section there, that's the back of the work, so that's your back of your sweater. Then we're going to, so we've worked our increase, it's all in that same stitch. We're now going to double crochet into the next four stitches, or however many that you need to do. Into the next stitch, we're going to work an increase, so we're going to go and do double crochet, chain one, and a double crochet all into the same chain. Just grabbing some yarn, and now I need to double crochet into the next 12 stitches. And with a bit of luck, that will be what we have remaining there. And you will have a different amount if you are using, if you're following a different size. And I have 12 stitches, yeehaw. I really do love that feeling of that first row when you get it right. And it says now to slip stitch into the third chain of the chain four to join. So the beginning chain four, we didn't actually make a chain four, but we did skip four chains. And we want to join into the third one. So if you see here, you've got one, two, three and four. So you want to go to the third one, so that's there. So you're going to have a chain one here, and that, remember how we did our increase of double crochet, chain one, double crochet? That's what this is here. So we need that chain one there. So we're going to grab our yarn and pull that through, and then pull that through there. and that has joined it. And see how it's got this really strange looking space? This is what this yarn tail is, that we're going to use it at the end, and we're going to sew that closed. So it says on the ribbon pattern, make sure you crochet into each double crochet, and when you get to the end of the round, double crochet into the top of the third chain of the chain four from the previous round. And that is going to make much more sense when we get to it. So what it's meaning, we are going to slip stitch across here. That's our next part of our instructions. Slip stitch across. But when we come back around, see this chain four, so it'll be a chain four that we did here. So it's three chains and then I'll chain one here. So into our third chain, we have to make sure we crochet into the top of there. So it'll actually be here. Because if we don't, every time we get round here, you're going to be one stitch short and it's not going to look right. It won't look even all the way around. So what we do, we've slip stitch into the chain one space. We're going to chain up four. So one, two, three, and four. And do one double crochet in the same space that we just did our chain four. So in there, work a double crochet. And we're going to double crochet in all the double crochets. And when we get to our chain one space, which is here, where we did our increase before on the previous round, we're going to work a increase. So it's pretty easy. We double crochet in the double crochets, and in the chain one space, we do our increase. So I'm going to work my way across. Don't forget, if I'm crocheting too fast for you, you can always pause the video. Once we get to our chain one space, which is here, we're going to go in there and work our increase. And it's a double crochet, chain one, and double crochet. So that's the last time I'm going to say that, because you will get sick of me saying double crochet, chain one, double crochet, if you're not already. So when I say increase, that's what it means. So now into our double crochets across until we find our next chain one space, which is here. And as we go along, the chain one spaces will stand out a lot more, because you'll see, you can almost see it starting to form here. See how you've got the holes, those holes here, which is our chain one spaces. They're going to start to stand out a lot more and it'll remind you easily to do your increase. So we're going to double crochet across. And then when we get to here, with our chain one space, we're going to work an increase. And remember, it's all worked into the chain one space. And we'll repeat this all the way around. So now we've got more double crochets here, so we're going to work into those. Make sure when you do this second double crochet here, that you don't accidentally crochet over this stitch and hide that hole there. Otherwise, again, your stitch count is going to be out and we don't want any tears at the end. So we're coming up to our chain one space, which is here, and we're going to work our increase. And we're going to do this all the way around. So you think you've got one more left? You might not. No, we don't have any left. So we're just going to double crochet across. And I'll meet with you when we're ready to join. And I'll show you what I mean about double crocheting in that chain three or chain four from the previous round. So I'm coming up to the last part of my work. And you'll see I have a double crochet there to go into. So we're going to work that one. And if you're not paying attention, it kind of looks like we don't have any more stitches. But see this chain here? We have to work into the top of that stitch. So yarning over, and I think it's a slip stitch. I can't actually remember. So we're going to double crochet into that there. Might be a little bit stubborn to get into there, but should be all right. So working our double crochet, and then we're going to join to the third chain. So 1, 2, 3. I like to get that loop there, and then that loop at the back there. Doesn't always work, but I try and get it if I can. So we are going to repeat the last round that we just did, and then if we look at our pattern and the measurements that we took, just quickly finding mine, we are going to compare this to the neck measurement that we took. And we're actually going to compare it to the garment if we've got the garment as well. So I'm going to insert another photo here where I've compared the neck to my garment. You will notice that it's a cardigan. It's actually got a split in the neck. It's not joined, but it is exactly the same method and it's got exactly the same chains. So yeah, don't pay any attention because you may notice it's got a split in there, but trust me, it is the exact same way. So what we need to do is fold our neck down. If we line up our two little chain one spaces there, and then on the other side as well, you'll notice, we should be able to notice, just that it starts to curve up at the top there, and that's our shoulder. And then same on the other side. So you're going to place this onto your garment, and like I said, you'll see a photo and you're going to compare that. And then this measurement here, you could compare that to the measurement that you took. So what did I get? I got 30 centimeters, so that's like 12 inches. Now don't forget the crochet stretches. So 12 inches, that's my neck hole that I need. And I try and compare that. This is a little bit tricky to do. You'll see that it's just about the measurement that I need. And like I said, it's going to stretch. Like, I'm not going to stretch it out, but it will stretch. We do put some little one or two rounds in the neck with single crochet, but it will still stretch out. So just bear that in mind when you're measuring all that bits and pieces. So now what we want to do is we are going to crochet, repeating the last round, until we have the next measurement, which here is the armhole. And mine is 3.5 inches. So I need to keep crocheting until from the neckline, which is this first row, and measured down that way is 3.5 inches. So it'll get longer and longer as you work your way. So in the next video clip, you'll see how much I've done. So I have my work done, and it says, I read my measurement wrong before. That was my scribble. It was 3 to 3.5 inches. So when I measure it, comes out that just under 3.5, so that's good to go. So the next step, I'm just organizing my instructions. We are now going to join our piece of work that we have here, and it's going to create the armholes. So pop that back on there. So what we're going to do, we're not going to slip stitch across into that chain one space. We're going to chain four. This counts as our very first double crochet and a chain one. And the chain one is going to be under your arm. We're going to skip the chain one space. We're going to skip all of these double crochets. So skipping all those double crochets. We're going to skip the chain one space. and double crochet. See, our chain one space is here. Double crochet in the next double crochet. And then we are going to double crochet all the way across until we get to our next chain one space. Pause the video and I'll meet you there. We're up to our next chain one space, which is there. So I've done a double crochet in that double crochet. We're going to chain one. Don't do that very tight. We're going to skip the chain one space. We're going to skip the next lot of double crochets and that chain one space, and then double crochet in the next stitch. And what this is doing when we're skipping all our double crochets, it's creating the armhole of our sweater. And you can see there we have an armhole. So now what we need to do is double crochet all the way across, and then we are ready to join. So I'll pause video and I will meet you when we are ready to join. So we have our, remember how we had to like double crochet in the top there, but we don't need to do that because we've already done that when we did our chains from the previous, from the beginning of the row, the round. So we're going to slip stitch into the third chain. So 1, 2, and 3, and that fourth chain, make sure I'm doing this right, the fourth chain is our chain one. So 1, 2, 3. I think I may have only done 3 chains, but I'm going to slip stitch into the one just before the chain. If I did, you would have had, it doesn't, you can't notice, it doesn't look any different, so that's all right. I'm sorry if I did do 3 instead of 4 there. I'll edit the pattern, so edit the video so it'll be on the screen to tell you to do 4. Okay, so where are we up to now? Now we're up to the body section of our work. And the body section is actually worked in a spiral so that there's no joining. Because at the moment, our joining is on this increase here and it doesn't stand out very much. If we continue on doing that and join each round, I don't know if you've ever made a hat and when you go to join it, you get that joining seam and it really stands out. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a spiral and we won't get any joining seam because there's not going to be any joining. You can work this part in 1 or 2 colours. If you want to do 2 colours, you're going to do whatever colour, so you might continue on with the pink here and then you're going to join your other colour. Let me just lay this flat for you. So we continue on with our pink on this side. If you want to do another colour, and what we'll do is make the body section striped, join it over this side, and you will join it. I would join it in that chain one space that's under the arm there, and you're going to do exactly the same thing as what we're about to do on the other side. So you would join in your yarn so that you are ready to go. Okay, this one starts on our double crochet, but so you could join it into the double crochet on the other side. What we're going to do is we're going to chain one and we're going to work a single crochet, and this just starts off our spiral. The next stitch we do is a half double crochet. We're going to yarn over and we're going to go into the chain one that we made on the previous round. Can I get the 2 loops? Yes, I can. So it's a half double crochet, so we've got 3 loops and then yarn over, pull through all 3. And now we're just going to choose the double crochet stitch and we're going to work this all the way around. So from now on, it's a double crochet stitch. And just there is the only section that will have the different stitch to the rest. And because it's under the arm, it's not going to notice very much at all. And being all the same colour, it probably won't notice. So we're going to continue around. And when we get to the chain one space, we're actually going to crochet into it. If you have joined your other colour so that you want to do two colours on the body, and it's going to be striped. If you want to do that, this will look different because you'll have your other colour attached, but because we're using one colour, it's not there. So we just crochet around. So on the next bit, I'm going to show you what to do. I'm going to crochet around first, but the next video clip will show you what to do when we come back to where we've got our single crochet and our half double crochet. And if you've done two colours, you are about to come up to that here, but we're not because we only have one colour and it's just the same. So I'm hoping this makes sense. If you're doing two colours, you will have this bit here over this side because you started your new colour there as well. You're going to have it on both sides, but then when we come around, what we do is we just crochet along, and where it steps up there, we just crochet in there, and then in, we don't go in the chain one, we go in there and we work our way around. But I'm going to show you that in a minute what to do. So whether you've got one colour or two colours, that process there is exactly the same. So pause the video and I will be back when we are over here and I'll show you what to do. So as we come around, you may have the same colour or you may have a different colour. It's the exact same process. We're just going to double crochet in the very first stitch that we did, which was a single crochet, and then we are just going to continue around. And from now on, we double crochet in every stitch around. And we do this until we have the length that we need. Now, my length says I need 6 inches, and I took that from the waist, the back measurement. So I think the measurement was from the neck to the waist. I can't remember what it was called on that link that I gave you. I think it's called the back waist measurement. And it says 6 inches, but looking at this, I think stitching 6 inches might be a little bit short, which is telling me that it's literally to their waist. And when you make a sweater, it's normally a bit longer. So I think I may need to make this just a little bit longer, but you'll know by looking at it if it's going to be way too short. So continue around until you have the length that you need, and when we stop, we're going to stop on the same side as where we joined our yarn, which if you want to, it's very easy to see. That's just double crocheted straight across, and then you'll see the little tiny stitches there. Let's see if we've got a stitch marker handy. Let's just pop that in there. You don't have to, it's just to remind me what side to stop at. So if you've got two colours, one side will stop here. So whatever colour you started over here, you're going to stop on this side when you've got your length. And whatever colour you started on this side, you're going to stop your colour on that side as well. Because then what it will do is be a one continuous round and you won't sort of finish on half a round. So continue on until you got your length. I thought I would just tell you that in case I forget to tell you when I come back, because it's about 6 o'clock here now and I'm pretty sure I'm not going to film till tomorrow and I may forget to tell you the information. So we're going to continue on until we have the length that we need and I will meet you back and we'll be ready to do the bottom band. I have the length that I want to do before I do the band, and I've done from the joining. The joining round, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and you want to finish on the same side as where you joined your yarn, so it's over here, not where you joined your yarn, but where you started the single crochet and you started to do your spiral. Sorry, I'm working on another project, which is, that's where you joined the yarn, but not in this project. So what we want to do now is to start the edging on the sweater. What we're going to do is on the next stitch, we're going to do a half double crochet . We're going to single crochet in the next stitch, and then we're just going to we're going to single crochet in the next stitch, and each stitch around until we have the amount of rounds that we want for the bottom band. Now, this size I'm making is, it's sort of doll size or newborn, so I'm only going to do one or two rounds of the single crochet around the bottom. And don't work them too tight, otherwise it's going to make the bottom of the sweater just pull in really tight, and it's not going to fit someone. So I'm just going to continue around. I'm going to do I'm thinking two rounds of single crochet. And after we do this, we are ready to do the sleeves, or we can do the neck opening. So I'm just going to finish this off, and I'll meet you when I've done about two rounds. I've done my two rounds, and I'm up to the same side as where the stitch marker is. And I think I just need to do maybe one more stitch. Yep. I'm just doing one more stitch, so I'm up to the, what would be the side seam if there was a side seam. So when you lay it flat, when you lay it flat and you work your way across, just on the side bit there, then our next stitch is going to be a slip stitch, and then we're going to finish off. So grabbing your scissors. And then we're going to sew in our ends. And I like to do this to the back of my work, so I just turn it to the inside. And I just go through the back of the stitch there. And then work my way across. Sorry if the lighting is a little bit glary, but it's raining outside, and it's really quite gloomy. It's making these lights quite bright. I'm not sure if you can actually tell a difference, but I can because I sit in front of them a lot. Okay, so there's our ends sewn in. Trim them off. And we can take that stitch marker out. And let's do the neck first. So where our neck is, there's this gap. So we're just going to, I'm going to just snip that off a bit. I'm going to thread our needle, and you would have left a reasonably long tail. You're going to go to the next stitch across to the right here, and find, get it out. This is our increase from our first row. So there's one there, and our chain one is in here somewhere. So just not the next stitch from where we are joining. So not that one. That's our chainy bit. This is our double crochet. And just find where that's going into the chain. And we're just going to put it through there. And what I like to do is just come back around to the front and go between the legs of the double crochet, so go in there, and then grab that loop before you pull tight, and that will just secure that in place. So now we can just sew in our ends, and if you want to, you can just sew back through there to make it a bit more secure. It's up to you. We're actually going to crochet over this, so we're not going to see it. again, I like to go to the inside and work in my tail. And then just work it back. And you always skip a couple of stitches at the beginning where a yarn's coming out just here. You skip a couple of stitches and then go in the next ones, and that just traps your yarn into your work, and it won't pull it back through again when you go this way. It'll get stuck there. So snip that off. So now when we want to work, my brain's going faster than my mouth, our neck opening, we are going to crochet into, you'll see the double crochet here, and it's got two legs. There's one there, there's one here, and there's one on that side. And in the middle there, that is where we're going to put our crochet hook. You can work your crochet into your chain loops from the very first round, but I find it makes holes, and if that's not the look that you're after, then we won't do that. But if you want like little holes around the opening, then give it a go and see how you like that. Is there a back and a front? Not really, because this is the same all the way around. So we're going to join our yarn. Really join it anywhere, but I'm going to join it on where the increase is over here and just put it onto the side. So just lay your yarn on the top and then pull through. I'm going to try and crochet over my tails as I go. Chain one just to secure, pull down on that yarn, and we're going to single crochet in the very first same stitch that we just joined our yarn in there. Join that in there. Hang on, I've got a really big loop. Single crochet. And in each stitch between the leg of the double crochet, we're going to work a single crochet. If you want to make your neck opening tighter, then you can work a couple of single crochet decreases. On the baby cardigan video that I did, I actually work decreases. When we come up here, we've got an increase from the previous row. We've got one there, one there. I actually work a decrease over those two stitches. So that's another way that you can do that. That's on the baby cardigan video, which just gives you a different look. Makes the neck opening a bit tighter, but with this sweater I just don't think that we're going to need to make it any tighter. But if you do, if maybe the neck opening's too big, then that's something that you can do. And we're just going to do this all the way around in every single stitch, but I'm going to show you what I did because you may not be able to find it very quickly on the cardigan video. Please go and check it out though if you want to. It's a really good video. Really cute cardigan for babies. So you would just single crochet in there and then single crochet there and then all the way around if you don't want decreasing. But if you want to decrease, you're going to go into the legs like we have been doing, and you're going to pull up a loop, but instead of pulling that one through, leave the two loops on there. Go into the next stitch between the legs and pull up a loop. Got three loops, yarn over and pull through all stitches, and that is a single crochet decrease. And that's what I did every time I got to where the increases were on the first round, that I just worked a decrease. But that was on the cardigan, so you've got sort of more leeway because you don't need to, you can open the cardigan open up when you put it on, so you don't need to worry about the neck opening being way too tight. But with the sweater you do, because that's the only entrance. There's no way making it bigger like undoing buttons. So work your way around. Again, I'm going to work two rounds of single crochet, and I'll meet you when we're ready to do the sleeves. Oh my gosh, this is looking so cute. It's looking just adorable. So we've done the bottom, we've done our top around the neck, and now we're going to work our sleeves. If you want to make it short sleeve, you can do single crochet all the way. I will be starting with a single crochet, then a half, and then a double, and then continue on with double crochet around. But if you just want to make a short sleeve, when I change to the double crochet, you're just going to keep continuing on with your single crochet. So we always join the yarn underneath the arm, and it doesn't really matter what side you start on. I'm going to pick this side. So when we look at our work, you will have a chain stitch down here. Do you remember when we did a chain under the arm? We did it like a one chain, and Babe mentioned to do one or more chains. But it doesn't matter where you join, but it is going to be at the very bottom part of our crochet, of our armhole. So the armhole's there. If you can find where the bottom is, that's where we're going to join it in. And the stitches that go around here, we are going to work into the between the legs bit, but once we get up around here, you'll see it's just normal crochet, so we can just work into where we would normally work. Just around the opening here, we've got sort of funny stitches, so we're just going to work in there. So we're going to join our yarn in, and we're going to single crochet in our first stitch. Into our next stitch, so it all just looks like a bunch of stitches at the moment. Our next stitch, I'm going to not sew over, crochet over, that's too confusing. So we've joined there, our next stitch is here, and then there's one there. So our next stitch is a half double crochet, and the reason we start with single, then a half, then a double, is we're working in a spiral, and it makes it a lot easier for when we come around on the next round. So that's a half double crochet. We've got here, so that can be a double crochet, and from now on it's just double crochet. So around the opening here, there's not really an exact spot to go, is there, really? Just on this side bit, you just gotta figure out where you want to put it. And if you've got a really big gap, it means that you've spaced your stitches out too much, so just go back a bit and put a stitch in there. And here we've got a chain one space from the beginning, the yoke part, so we're going to double crochet into there, and then in each stitch we're going to double crochet. So now it's just normal, your placement of your stitches in the normal spot when you crochet normal. So I'm just going to keep the camera going, but I may speed it up a little bit just for the video's sake, so the tutorial's not too long. So after we've done our chain one space, we are going to go into the side of this stitch here. And then we've got one stitch down here, and we can go between the legs of that one. And then we're just going to work our way around. So this next stitch is the single crochet that we started with. We're going to double crochet in the top of that. And then we're just going to keep going around. And remember, if I said you want to do a short sleeve, just work single crochets instead of double crochets. You're going to keep going. If you're doing a short sleeve, two rounds is probably going to be enough just to give it a little neat edge. And if you're doing the short sleeve, you make it until it's long enough. If you don't know how long to make it, I will insert the link. I'm pretty sure I've already mentioned this in the beginning of the video, but I will insert the link to the sizes that I use. I found a chart or information online, so I will be using that. I don't know what it is yet. I've got to go and have a look. I forgot to look it up before I sat down. but I will be using that, and then when I come back in the next part of the video, you're going to see it anyway, so you'll know how long to make it. And I'm going to continue with my sleeve, and then I'll be back to show you the edging. So I finish my sleeve, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rounds. It measures approximately 5 inches. This is more like a preemie size. I just checked the chest measurement, and it's sort of like big preemie, small newborn. So for this, we are going to basically do what we did on the band on the bottom, and we're going to half double crochet. Oh, and I've stopped my crochet at the underarm seam, if there was one. So you can see that's the seam, and that's where I've stopped. So we're going to half double crochet in the next stitch and single crochet in the next one. Then I'm going to work 2 rounds of single crochet, and I'm going to finish off and sew in my ends. And after I've done this one, I'm going to do exactly the same on the other sleeve. So I'll complete the rest of that off the camera. But it's looking so, so cute. Can't wait for it to be finished. Here is my finished sweater, and it is so cute. I've sewn in all my ends. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share your creations on our Facebook page or tag me on Instagram. I would love to see what you have made. Also, now I'm on Patreon, so if you would like to support me over there, I would really appreciate that. I'll put a link that you need in the description box. We will be having all sorts of giveaways. There's also heads up on new video tutorials. There's early bird links that you can see video tutorials before it's released on YouTube. So very exciting. All the information that you need is over on Patreon, and the link for that is in the description box. Again, I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching, and until next time, happy crochet!